Seems we're all in for a treat, staring up at all the street. And you can't tell that Joe is really glad that he came. The damn wind of him trails, the fog of alcohol. He fails to do his best to be indifferent or the same. But there ain't no shaking the smell, like there ain't no shaking the spell. As Blondin Wire Walker braves the screams, Joe is always impressed, though he has something to confess. Above the sound of 10,000 creaking necks all craned, he says, alone among the beasts and freaks, I dreamt of tightrope walking while I attended Blondin's Percherons and trailers. I'd see him training in the evening. There was no point trying to speak, you see. I doubted that he'd have time for the strangers who'd be there hoisting up his big tents, be there spying him from their knives, staring down on them like batshit in a cave. Well, we hardly even met. See, I worked for him. I thought I'd fill the space he left, but no, I was naive. Just another sideshow slow. I thought he knew something I don't. But it would seem all these wire walkers have is just a means to make you feel so bad. Man, no one cared for him at all until he crossed Niagara Falls. So you'd all feel a little lower down the scale. And then his fame shot straight and fast right through a gloomy narrow pass. It chanced through darkness, lightning, storms, and into day. But I ain't here because he's tall. I'm only here to see him fall. And if I get on the wagon now, it'll only be to run him down. Joe's been drinking all his breath. But then the clouds part overhead, and I make out the silhouette as though I'm staring up through a trapdoor, and I'm waiting to